Hey guys, how's it going? I just picked up my brand new 2016 F-150 Ford truck, and it's just a leftover, so great deal. I'm lucky enough I get AZ plan pricing, so that helps drastically, and plus the discounts were like $6,000 at A plan. I think total was just over, a little over 10 savings. So I just got a work truck model, so notice people don't really talk about that too much, so I figure I'd bring it to you.
So as you notice, with a work truck, you get like a plastic bumper. You can still get different colors. This is caribou. You get steel rims. This has the 2.7 liter Ecoboost, which has pretty good reviews. It has the FX4 package, so it has the off-road package that has skid plates underneath. It has side steps, as you notice. It's a 6.5 foot bed, so you don't get the tailgate step dealy bopper. This is the bed and tie down points in each corner, and way up there, if I can zoom in, I'm gonna have LineX probably done to go talk to the guy. Maybe I'll do that today. See if he's there. It's pretty basic, really. I mean, it's a work truck. So pretty much you go to a dealer and you say, I'm not going to pay 40, 50 grand for a truck. So, you know, let's look at work trucks. And so this is the super crew. So the door opens flush. This is how wide that door opens. So pretty big entryway. Plenty of room back here. I have the seat medium, I guess, because I'm not too tall. And I can sit back here with my legs like that. Most guys sit. I'm fine. Passenger up, plenty of leg room. I don't have anyone old that's gonna be sitting in the back. No adults. Have a young kid. And young kids, plenty of room. Plenty of room for a car seat. So you can flip these up, 60-40. Boom. Flip up that. Got all this floor space. You get a cigarette lighter, power jack there. That flips down, you get cup holders. Not bad, that's it for that. Well, it looks like I have some bed hooks. Don't know if that was part of this package or what. I'll have to see how those install. That's pretty quick for box link cleat instructions. Oh, probably in there lockable. So this, I'll do a separate video, must go into those cleats. Cool, I didn't even know that. That's awesome. So I'll need that for a good tie down point for my ratchet point for my bike. One there. I'll probably do some type of bar or something down the road on the back just to have a middle point. But that's pretty cool. I didn't even know that came with. I did see the box in here when I was looking at the vehicle, but I didn't really, you know, look what's in the box. I assumed they put everything together, and they didn't. So we'll put that in here, put there so I remember. But yeah, you got a big area under the seat here. It's kind of dipped, which is nice because I could lay some stuff there and it's not going to slide out. Like I could put, you know, my toe straps and stuff. You know, a lot of room over there as a vent for air. This does have the little jump seat, so you have that. Thing I'm going to do is pull off a headrest. People talked about it. Do that in a separate video. Show you guys how. And then this, however it works,
Yeah, so a little latcher pull.
It's a nice hit, kind of hidden cubby. I see somebody makes a vault system if you do the whole conceal carry and have a permit, depending on your state, you can get a vault that goes in here, so it's lockable. And if you didn't want the cup holders on somebody who's riding, you just pop it off. Like that. It goes in those tabs. Pretty cool. But that headrest gets in the way of down there. See people complain online. It's kind of annoying. And there's a button on the other side. You press and that folds back down. I don't plan to carry anyone up here, so I don't really care about the headrest part. If I did, it would probably be really local, right? You're not going far. Inside, you got the power windows, power mirrors, window lock. Lock your door. Go kind of get in, I guess. Show you guys. Automatic lights, so I get automatic lights still. Interior, I guess, turn on your lights, parking lights off. Bed light, so I still get a bed light, and this dims and brightens your gauge. And parking brake, just pull on that. Hood release is there. You get trailer, so I still get trailer control. Get a USB port down here. This is a kind of goofy spot. That's where I have my glasses. The headrest also kind of blocks this access, so no reason to remove it. Get a power jack right there. You get one up here, 12 volt. Basic controls. It's a work truck, remember? But less likely stuff to break. Still has a CD player here. Your eject button. You have your, you know, your volume, your tune, scroll through the menus, your keypad, CD that still connects to my phone with Bluetooth, also USB, if you want to wire it. Like I said, it has CD, has hill descent, traction control off, your emergency, and to turn on and off your automatic shutoff. If you're at a light too long, the 2.7 liter, this will shut off to save fuel in town. And as soon as you go from brake to gas, it's like a hybrid. Restart seamlessly and you go. So, but you can control it and you can say, you know, I don't want to bother with that, you know, and just shut that system off. I also got sport mode, tow haul mode, and wipers, blinkers. They just go like that. Over here, I gotta be honest, I quite don't know what the plus and minus here is for yet. Oh, manual. So here, let's go ahead and start it. The keys look a little bit different. That's what it looks like. Like a switchblade. You just put it in. On the steering wheel. It's gonna tell me about all the doors. Okay. Which is smart enough, it knows that door's open. Well guys, I shut the doors and came back in, so it's pretty quiet in here. You know, you got your oil temperature, your coolant temperature, your fuel, and dealer was nice, they filled it completely full. And is that your transmission temperature, I believe, there? And you got your RPM and obviously your speed. In the middle, you got your park, reverse, neutral, drive, manual, 2 and 1. So I'm gonna guess that's what this does for fun. Let's go put it in there. Yeah, and if you can see right there, it says M1. Probably can't do much. M2.
and 3. That's all it's going to let me do right now. So put that back in park. Your middle information center. I'm not sure what they call it, but that's what I'm calling it. So you got your trip. This is apparently on trip 2. I'll have to figure out how to do all that. That's trip 1. All the way up is trip 1. If you notice, up in that corner, it tells you what you can do. I can go to the left or down on the arrow pad, which is right here. So, trip 1, trip 2, fuel economy. Obviously, press, I can hit that. It's going to reset. I can do fuel history, which I can reset. And compass, press OK for options, fixing it north or rotating. Say fix north. Engine on, normal operation. And so this is the main menu. You can go to the main menu. You apparently have a display mode. So, I can have it just show, sir, transmission temperature, 60. Tire pressure, there we go. Digital speedometer. Percentage oil life. Engine hours. Engine idle hour. My keys and 2 admin keys. Which I honestly don't know what that does yet. So, yeah, that's that. So, back main menu. Towing. Trailer said no active trailer. Trailer options. So, you can do sway control, select trailer, change trailer settings, add trailer. So, you can set it up to different trailers, apparently. Connection checklist. What type it is. I'll just go back because I don't have anything. Off-road. Off-road status. You know, that's just going to show you different, apparently different degrees that the vehicle's at. Now let's go down. Power distribution. It's going to show you where you're putting your power. And that's pretty much it for that. Settings. Normal or towing? Okay, calculate. I'm not sure what DTE means. Or towing. Obviously, I'll leave it at normal because I'm not towing. Advanced settings. A vehicle, my key, display setup. So, you can change all this. Fahrenheit, so depending where you live. I'm gonna guess that's what pretty much all this is for. Go back. Say vehicle, lighting, auto lamps, daytime lights. So I can turn that on or off. I'll just leave it on. Oh, auto lamps. So 20 seconds. Sounds good. Locks, auto lock, auto unlock. Remote unlock, go back, wipers, courtesy wipe, quite sure what that means, don't care, but just trying to show you guys a little more in depth in my video than other videos, not saying other videos are bad, just personally I kind of would just I kind of like that whole fuel history one, this one. Right there, fuel economy. I'll leave it there just so I can have fun watching that for a while. Like I said, you can press this, and it shows right by the odometer. Sport mode, off, standard. So that's how that pretty much works. I'll probably do another video how other stuff works because it gets pretty, long. Try to keep these a little on the shorter side for you guys. But
one more feature we'll do the, because the FX4 package, the 2 high, the 4,
which it will tell you, shifting in progress, and then 4 low, you need to put it in neutral. I'll go back to there, high, and then back to 2.
2 wheel, and if I want to lock the differential, just pull that, and then it's going to lock the rear. Just very basic. This is what you get on a work vehicle. You know, some people might not like this. You might want all the bells and whistles. I can't really justify it. I'm hauling my motorcycle around. So, you know, it's a truck. So there are things you don't get carpet, you know. I don't know why people care so much about carpet. People always cocoon the carpet, you know. So, yeah, I don't get that. So one last thing we'll look at, because it's an important part of the vehicle, is I'll go ahead and turn this bad boy off. But we're going to go ahead and look at the engine. So, guys, this is the engine of the 2.7 liter. Well, it's pretty dusty. And I'll probably kind of wash that out next time I'm out. Probably just from sitting in their lot. But anyways, this is the 2.7 liter. Make sure the cap there's on. Yeah. The battery, windshield washer fluid, your coolant, pretty easy being right there. Your brakes. And being a new truck, I bet it doesn't have a transmission dipstick. A rarity nowadays. But anyways, that's basically it. Too bad it doesn't have a transmission dipstick. But a lot of room in here with the 2.7. I mean, lots of space. Looks like stuff's well protected down in there. And the air cleaner is over there.
Air intake is right here.
So we'll do other videos about removing stuff, more maintenance type as time goes on here to show you guys. So you know, always check back with my channel and I'll make a playlist so it makes it easy for you guys.
Guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for checking this out. Hopefully I can bring you more on what I do and, you know, when I do maintenance items. So you can see an owner progressing through the years of owning this vehicle, and it might help you out, like removing that headrest. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and check out my other videos.